Hello and welcome back to Ashok Janardhanan's Guitar Lesson, and we are going to discuss about a new and very interesting topic today. It's called the parallel progressions. And before we move on to this, you'll have to know that songs are based out of keys. We have discussed this already in the beginner series. So if you have no clue of what I'm talking about, just go to this lesson in the link. Complete that lesson first and get back to this. You'll get a clearer idea of what I'm talking about. So for the rest of you, we know that if you're playing a song in a C major key, for example, you know, you can use the chords C major, D minor, E minor, F major, G major, A minor, B diminished, and back to C. So the songs would have any combination of these particular chords. Mostly, there are songs with two different keys or three different keys too. Don't worry about that now. Let's get to the basics. So for an example, I am playing a song in a C major key. I'll play the chord C major. So we've already learned this lesson previously in the beginner series. Now what is a parallel minor progression? It's basically borrowing chords from the parallel minor key, which means I'm playing song in a C major. The parallel minor for a C major is a C minor. It's that simple. Parallel progression for an A major is going to be an A minor. For a B major, it's B minor, C major, C minor. So that's the idea. So the triads in the C minor harmony is going to be C minor, D diminished, E major, F minor, G minor, A major, and B major. So to make it easier, I've listed the chords here for the major and minor keys. So for example number one, I'll start a song with a C major key. So I'll be playing a C major. And what I'm going to do now is, instead of playing an F major, which is the fourth chord in a C major key, I'm going to borrow the F minor chord from a C minor progression. We'll just see how it sounds like. 1, 2, 3, 4. You see, it still sounds good. It's giving you a dark feel. This is really something that's a little different than the regular progressions that we hear in the songs. It won't be predictable, that's the point. So the whole idea here is to borrow chords from parallel keys. So we can do the same thing with a minor progression as well. I can start a song with a C minor chord. So I'll play C minor, B flat, and I'll borrow the F chord from the C major. So see, the song still sounds good, but it gives a different flavor to the progression. Now, what also can be done is you can play C minor, you can start off with a minor key, you can play B flat, you can play the F major, I can finish off with a different key as well, I can finish off with the C major chord. The reason why it sounds good is because when you play the F major from a C major progression, I've already established that we have changed the key to a C major. So after the F major, you can start with the C. No harm, it'll still sound good. So I can borrow as much chords as I can. There's no restrictions to the number of chords that I can borrow, and no strict rules to make any progressions. Remember, it's your song, so you'll have to come up with your own idea to create the progression. So now let's try a crazy progression. I'll play a C major chord first. So it's a C major key. And for the second chord, I'll play an A flat major, that is from a C minor key. So I'm changing from a C major, C minor key, and I'll play the A minor from the C major key again. So I'm switching from major to minor and back to major again. So see, we'll just see how it sounds. So I'll repeat this again. It's your song, so you get to decide how many number of chords you want to shift. Now for the last example, I'll play a C minor progression. I'll play a C minor chord, an A flat, major, so I'm still in the C minor progression. I'll play an F. I'll play a G. So when I played the F, I've come back to the C major. I'm playing the G from the C major again. So I can end the last chord with a C minor, or I can go back to the C major again, because like I already mentioned, this when you switch back to the F major, you've established that the key is going to be a C major again. So I'll play it. I can finish off with a C major now. It's totally fine. So I hope you guys enjoyed this lesson. If you did so, then give me a thumbs up and share this video, and if you come up with any interesting progressions, let me know. You can comment in the comment section below. I'll catch you up in the next lesson.